Hello, lovelies. It is January 9th, 2019. And today I'm thinking a lot about how the body communicates with us. People take their bodies for granted. They think that little pains and sicknesses and symptoms are just results of their surroundings and things like that. But the truth is, your body is always giving you messages and it is attempting to help you along your path to awakening. There is a wonderful tool. Some of you have heard me talk about it before. It is a book by the glorious Louise Hay. It is called Heal Your Body A to Z. Now, she does have one called Heal Your Body, but that is not the one that I'm talking about today. I am talking about Heal Your Body A to Z. It is like a little dictionary of symptoms and illnesses and places in the body where you might be having a symptom. And the idea is that just the moment that you start to feel dis-ease, you look up that symptom or illness in the book. Now, what it's going to give you when you do is a probable cause and a new thought pattern to replace it with. And so, you know, itchiness is about being irritated, things like that. Now, the reason why this is heavy on my mind is because I have manifest over this holiday a sore throat. Now, my sore throat, the other symptoms that I have that go with it, and the symptoms I'm missing have a really interesting message. And I thought that sharing it with you might be helpful. So this holiday, as all of us do, I spent time with friends and family in an environment that was very just social. Right? So this is not a place for me to give him one advice to relay universal messages or anything else. This is just a time to be with people. Now, starting with an evening that we spent with a couple that we are friends with, I started to manifest the very early symptoms of this sore throat. Now, this couple, they are friends of ours. I love them dearly. But one of the two of them, both of them technically, but one of them in particular is super negative. And as I do have the effect on people that they spill their guts to me, whenever we are together, this individual tells me horrific things and can see no light at the end of any tunnel, has made gross assumptions about what her future and her children's futures are going to be like based on her actually very narrow, limited view of life in the world. Now, more than anything, I want to take this human being apart and put them back together. But I can't. This person has never come to me as a client, has never directly asked me for any type of advice, just tends to chew my ear off when we are together. So I had to swallow my words, right? I had to just listen and be present. And of course, if you look in the Louise Hay book, what it says is that a sore throat is caused by the inability to speak up. It also suggests that it's about swallowing anger. Well, I wasn't swallowing any anger, but I was definitely holding on to my tongue and my frustration and my advice and my desire to tell her that she was causing all of these things in her world. So the sore throat makes sense, right? Along with the sore throat, over time, we spent more time with more family, more people who, as many do, have a tendency to tell me things they don't tell other people, and yet were not with me in a capacity for me to correct them or guide them or give them advice of any kind. And as this progressed, I started to develop a headache. Now, Louise Hay suggests that headaches are caused by fear or invalidation of the self. Now, while that's not directly what was going on, I certainly was putting the energy that I could not speak up, right? It wasn't fear per se, but definitely that this person would be offended or upset because that is not what they were coming to me for. And so that does explain the headache. Progress more time, more people, more conversations. My lymph nodes began to swell and get sore, right? Now, this is about clogged ideas. And the suggestion that's given by Louise Hay in the book is that the mind needs to be recentered on what is essential, on love and on joy. Now, I could argue that that's what I really want to do for these other people, but it was a reminder to me, okay, I am putting more of my energy on keeping my trap shut and trying not to judge than I am on just being joyful that I am present, that I'm in this environment, that this human being feels the desire to connect with me. And so what do? We look for the lesson for us. The lesson for me is focus less on keeping my trap shut and more on just the fact that I'm having what is at least on one side a very meaningful conversation and definitely the connection between two friends or two family members. Now, fast forward a couple more days and a few more conversations, and I did start to get a little cough. Cough is the desire to bark at the world. It is like saying, listen to me, listen to me. Oh my gosh, that makes a lot of sense because I was so focused on how much I just wanted to help them and correct them that I was missing, well, the lymph nodes of it all. So thank you, universe, for helping me see clearly. Now, if I hadn't been looking at the symptoms, right, I would just think, oh, my kids brought home something, right, or I'm tired or whatever. But there's always more to it than that. Right? Yes, circumstances can cause symptoms, but where they manifest does have a message. For example, I had missing symptoms in if this was like a cold or a flu, right? No congestion. Well, congestion is mental confusion and negative beliefs. At no point in time was I mentally confused or did I give in to negative beliefs, therefore no congestion, right? Another symptom that seems obvious with the others would be a fever. No fever at all. Fevers are a manifestation of anger. I also didn't manifest any kind of infection. If you look into my throat, there's no sign of it being infected, right? Infection, again, anger, annoyance. I did have a temporary symptom along the way. One afternoon, I had the chills. I just could not get warm. Well, chills are about wanting to pull away, wanting to run away and retreat. Yes, I wanted to do that. I sure did. Everybody around me was in a bad mood at one point, and I just wanted to run away and go hide. So that makes perfect sense. And I share this with you as sort of a tool, a guide, an example of diagnosing your own symptoms, right? It's important that we pay attention because the universe does like to speak to us through our body. And if we're not getting the whispers in the back of our heads and back of our ears, right? It will communicate through our bodies. And yet sometimes even people who use the tool get too literal, right? Just like I said at some of the first symptoms, if I were to literally look at what she said very specifically, very directly, and without any interpretation, it might not make sense to me. So it's important that we do that as well. So recognize, lovelies, our body is a manifestation of what's going on within us. And if you haven't already, get yourself a copy of this book. When I receive information directly about symptoms and illnesses and I check her book, we agree. So to me, it validates me because Louise Hay is amazing. And also it does validate this as a really good tool for you and me and anyone else. So again, it is called Heal Your Body A to Z by Louise Hay. You can get it on Amazon. If you look and it's really expensive, wait a couple days, look again. Usually it should be in the 20-something dollar range. I definitely suggest getting yourself a copy. I think it's a great addition to your library. And even though there's an app, the book is just more easily accessible. I hope that each and every one of you will take the time to listen to your body. It is one of the most important tools you have on this path to awakening. Until next week, lovelies. Namaste.